Let's consider one more special problem, which is Armstrong numbers. So let's get started. Here's the problem statement. Write a program to check whether a number is an Armstrong number or not. We need to write a program which checks whether a number is an Armstrong number or it is simply not an Armstrong number. But wait, what is an Armstrong number? That is the first question we need to address. So let's see what an Armstrong number is all about. An Armstrong number of order n is a number in which each digit, when multiplied by itself n number of times and finally added together, results the same number. Now what does it really mean? Let's consider one example. Here in this example, as you can see, we have a number 371 and it's a 3-digit number, right? Therefore, the order of this number is 3, right? Now what we do is, we simply have to multiply each digit of this number 3 times. And then we simply add them together. We are multiplying each digit 3 times here. And then we add them together to obtain the final result. Now as you can see, the final result obtained is equals to the actual number. Therefore, we can say that it is an Armstrong number. This is what we need to understand about the Armstrong numbers. An Armstrong number of order n is a number in which each digit, when multiplied by itself n number of times and finally added together, results the same number. How to write a program which checks whether a number is an Armstrong number or not? There are some steps that we need to follow. This is the step number one. We need to find out how many digits are there in your number. Why I need to find out the number of digits? As I already told you, we first have to find out what is the order of that particular number. If we would be able to find out the order, then we would be able to multiply each digit of that number those many times, right? That's why it is important to find out the order of that number. Here is the program which helps us in finding the order of a particular number. We have a variable count. We initialize it to 0. Inside this while loop, we are checking this condition is q equals to 0 or not. Let us assume that initially q is our actual number. If it is equals to 0, we simply get outside of this loop, right? Now inside this while loop, as you can see, we are dividing q by 10. As we already discussed in the previous presentation, if we divide the number by 10, then we get the exact number except the last digit, right? We simply store this result inside this q variable again and we increment the value of count. Count is initially 0. After that, we simply increment the value of count. Now, how this program helps us to find out the number of digits? Let's see one example. Here in this example, as you can see, I have chosen one number, 371. We are simply dividing this number by 10. As we divide this number by 10, the quotient that we get is 37. This is the number which is the number except the last digit, right? Now, after that, we simply increment the value of count as according to this procedure. Now, count contains 1, right? And then we again repeat the process, but this time we are choosing this number, that is 37. As you can clearly see, we are checking this condition is q equals to 0 or not. As q contains 37 now, as 37 is not equals to 0, therefore we again continue the same process. In the second step, we are dividing 37 by 10 and we simply store the quotient inside q. And then after that, we simply increment the value of count. Now count contains 2. We again repeat the same process as q is not equals to 0. Now we divide 3 by 10. Now we get quotient equals to 0. We again increment the value of count. Now count contains 3. We again check the condition, is q equals to 0 or not? Now q is equals to 0. Therefore, we get outside of this loop. The final count value is 3. Now, can you please tell me what this 3 means? This is nothing but number of digits, right? Now the logic that we need to understand is quite simple. Here, every time we are dividing the quotient by 10, so that we would be able to reduce the number by 1. Initially, we are reducing 371 to 37. Then 37 to 3 and then 3 to 0. In this way, we would be able to count the number of digits. We are maintaining the count variable so that we would be able to store the number of digits that we have. Right? So this program helps us to count the number of digits. Let's consider our second step. Second step simply says that multiply each digit n number of times and simply add them. In our case, n is 3. As we know, we have chosen the number 371. Its order is 3, therefore n is 3. Now we have to multiply each digit 3 times and finally add them together. How can we do that? Let's see the code. Now as you can see inside this while loop, we are performing one step, that is we are dividing q by 10. But here instead of quotient, we are storing the remainder. We know mod function is used to calculate the remainder. Therefore, we are storing remainder inside this remainder variable. Now inside this while loop, we are checking this condition is count equals to 0 or not. We have chosen one variable cnt and initially we store the value of count inside it. We know count is 3, right? Therefore, we are storing 3 inside cnt. We are checking this condition is cnt is equals to 0 or not. If cnt is equals to 0, we come outside of this loop. But let's see what is there inside this while loop. Here inside this while loop, we are multiplying the remainder 3 times. Here initially, mul value is equals to 1. We are multiplying 1 with remainder. And then we simply decrement the value of count. In this way, we repeat this process 3 times. This while loop helps us to multiply each digit 3 times according to our example, right? After that, we are storing the result inside the result variable. We initialize again cnt to count. And then after that, we divide q by 10 so that we would be able to store the quotient. And then again, we initialize mul to 1. Now let's see how this code works with the help of an example. As we are dividing 371 by 10 and we want to store the remainder, therefore we are storing the remainder, that is 1, inside this remainder variable. After that, we simply execute this while loop. Initially, cnt is equals to 3. As 3 is not equals to 0, therefore we come inside this while loop. We will simply multiply the remainder by 1. As because mul variable initially contains 1. We multiply 1 by 1, therefore mul will contain 1 only. We decrement the value of cnt, now cnt will contain 2. We again check the condition and again multiply 1 with remainder. And we do this process 3 times. After that we add mul to result. Result initially is 0, therefore 0 plus 1 is 1. Therefore result contains 1 now. Now the next step is to divide q by 10. Q is 371, we divide this number by 10, now Q contains 37, right? We again repeat the same process. Now 37 is divided by 10, remainder would be 7. We multiply 7 3 times with the help of this while loop, again repeating the same process. As cnt is equals to 3, 3 is not equals to 0, therefore we come inside this while loop. As remainder is 7 and mul is 1, therefore, we multiply 1 with 7 and store this particular number inside this mul. This time, mul contains 7. We decrement the value of cnt. Cnt now contains 2. We again check the condition. As condition is satisfied, we come inside again. Now, as we know, mul contains 7. We multiply 7 by 7 once again. As 7 into 7 is 49, therefore, now mul contains 49. We decrement the value of cnt. Cnt now contains 1. We again check the condition. Condition is satisfied. Now we multiply 7 with 49. As 49 into 7 is 343. And we store this 343 inside this mul variable again. We again decrement the value. Now the value of cnt is 0. The condition is false. Therefore we come outside of this while loop. And we are successful in multiplying 7 3 times. Which results in 343. After that we simply add result to the mul. Now result variable contains 344. Previously result value is 1. 1 plus 343 is 344. Again we repeat the same process. This time q contains 3. As 37 when divided by 10 is equals to 3. Again we repeat the same process. Multiply 3 by 3 times. And then finally add 27 to 344, which was the previous result. The final result we get is 371. This means the result variable now contains 371. Now let's try to understand the logic that we had followed. Here you're multiplying 1 3 times. Here you're multiplying 7 3 times. Here you're multiplying 3 3 times. That means you are actually multiplying each digit 3 times. That is what is decided, right? You have to multiply each digit n number of times. As n is equals to 3 in this example, therefore, we are successful in multiplying each digit 3 times. And after that, we simply add them together. The final result we are getting is 371. As you can clearly see, this logic is correct logic. Therefore, this program is the correct program. Let's consider the step number 3. What is going to be the final step? We need to check whether the calculated result is equal to the actual number or not. That is the final step. We need to check if result is equals to actual number or not. As we know, our result is equals to the actual number. Therefore, we can say that our number is an Armstrong number. If it is not equals to the actual number, then we simply say it is not an Armstrong number. Let's combine all these small code snippets together so as to obtain the actual program. As you can clearly see in this code, I have combined all those three code snippets that you can clearly see over here. Let's see whether this program runs correctly or not. It asks us to please enter a number. Suppose we enter a number 371. As we know, it is an Armstrong number, therefore it should result 371 is an Armstrong number. Let's see whether it results it or not. Yes, 371 is an Armstrong number. Therefore, our code works correctly. Let's execute it once more. Now this time, I add some other number which is not an Armstrong number. Let's say 890. It says 890 is not an Armstrong number. Okay. As our program is working fine, therefore we can say that this is a correct program. Okay friends, this is it for now. Thank you for watching this presentation.